Let's face it, guys, finding training packs in Rocket League sucks. There are about 10 packs featured that barely change month to month, and if you try to browse packs, there are absolutely no tools to help. So, I found a database of over 500 training packs in Rocket League, and since then, I have literally downloaded and reviewed every single one so I could select the best packs to practice for every rank in Rocket League. But before I reveal my top picks, only a small percentage of you all watching right now are subscribed to the channel. So if you haven't yet subbed, please consider subbing if you end up finding this video helpful. Remember, it's completely free to subscribe and you can always unsub whenever you want. Anyways, without any further wait, let's go over the best training packs for each rank in Rocket League. Alright guys, just so you know how I'm planning to do this, my plan is as follows. Working from the bottom up, I'm going to be giving you all my top 3 training packs for every rank, as well as an honorable mention or two, since I was finding it tough to limit my selection to just 3 packs per rank. But anyways, with all the formalities out of the way, let's get started. Alright, starting from the bottom in bronze, the first 2 training packs I'm going to recommend are literally just the pre-made Rookie Goalie and Rookie Striker training. I'm gonna be honest guys, if you're in bronze and you're actually watching this, really all you need to do to rank up is put the time in. Trust me, if you just simply practice hitting the ball consistently, you will rank up. Besides, the truth is, most training packs are made to train specific skills. And let's face it, if you're in bronze, you have none. But aside from the pre-made packs, I will give you one more training pack called Bronze to Silver training, which was actually made by my buddy Thanovic, so you at least have something besides the default packs. And for the bronze honorable mention, I'm going to actually go with Free Play, since once again, just learning how to move your car around in Free Play is something that will get you out of bronze. Alright, moving on to Silver, we can actually start getting into some real training packs. First up on my training pack list for silver players is a pack called Power Shots. Now, this pack is simple and pretty straightforward. Basically, what it's meant to do is help you build up that baseline ground control and steering ability of your car, which is something you definitely want to get down as you're moving through the silver ranks. Next up in the silver list, I'm going to give you another pre-made pack, but trust me, it's actually useful and it's Rookie Aerial Training. Now, once again, even though this pack is pre-made by Rocket League, it's the best one I could find to just train these shots a little bit above the ground, which is something that I've seen silver players struggle a lot with when I coach them. All right, last on the silver training pack list is a pack called Striking by none other than the pro, Rizzo. In short, this pack has a bunch of different shots that are going to train some challenging angles for silver players. But the reason I'm telling you to train it now in silver is because to score these shots, all you really have to do is make contact, right? It doesn't have to be good contact, it just has to be contact, period. And finally, in terms of honorable mentions for silver, I don't have a pack in specific, but I will use this time to stress something that all training packs can't train, which is recoveries and reads. Just remember that no training pack can really perfectly replicate any in-game situation. All right, guys, moving on to the gold rank, and one of my favorite packs that I recommend to so many players to kick it off is Ground Shots by Paquito. This pack is incredibly thorough, and I personally love it because it has shots that train all types of different angles. And truth is, when it comes to players at the gold ranks, there are probably a lot of things that could be trained, right? You could probably benefit from training recoveries, aerials, wall play, you name it. But before you can get to doing any of that, you need to learn how to just hit the ball hard. And trust me, there's so much in here from just shots to rebound setups to redirects that are really gonna help you expand your skills fast as a gold player. Now, my second pack for gold is starting to get into the territory of aerial play. It's a really good transition for gold players that are looking to get their car in the air. This pack is called Basic Rebound Practice, and the reason it makes this spot on my list is because of just how relevant this pack is to the gold level of play. From what I've seen coaching, shots like these that come back just slightly off the backboard are super common and are the perfect thing to work on for gold players. All right, onto my last pack for gold. I finally decided on a pack called Drift Catch Training by King Ranny. In my opinion, it is possibly the best pack at teaching new players how to control the ball. I honestly recommend this pack to people all the way up in the plat and diamond ranks because it's just that good at helping you learn how to use power slide to actually control the ball in open space. So if you haven't heard of this pack yet, don't sleep on it, definitely give it a shot. Lastly, the gold honorable mention is going to go to Rocket League's Pro Aerial Training. I promise this is the last pre-made pack I'm recommending, but seriously guys, before you go trying to do nutty aerial redirect packs, I think it's really important to train a pack like this to just hone in on your takeoffs and make sure you can actually score a ball that's sitting stationary. All right, on to training packs for platinum players. My first recommendation is going to be Luigi's Wall Play. Truthfully, I was debating whether or not to put this earlier in the gold bracket, but once you get to platinum, you're going to have to learn how to get off the ground, and so learning to play off the wall is just a non-negotiable. But moving on, next up in the plat bracket, you're also going to need to step up your aerial play. So I recommend checking out the pack called Double Jump Aerials by Doomzy. I like this pack a lot because it really forces you to get up in the air, but it's still a doable pack for a plat ranked player. So I highly, highly recommend you save this pack because there are so many things you can practice within it regardless of your rank. On to my last training pack for plats, and it's going to be none other than my favorite dribble trainer, Verge's Dribbling Pack. Once you start to push through to the higher ends of platinum, the just hit the ball strategy kind of starts to break down. As you start to approach diamond, you're going to need to learn how to actually control the ball and hit it with intention. Otherwise, you're rarely going to score when the defenders on the other team start to improve. So if you're not confident in your dribbling, flicking, and ability to catch the ball even, give this pack a shot because those mechanics are exactly what it trains. And before I forget, in terms of honorable mentions for plat, I'm going to go with a pack called Shadow Defense by Nimbus. Now, I know I haven't talked much about defensive training packs up until this point, and that's honestly because I believe if you can shoot a ball, you could probably save that same ball. However, that's not always the case, especially when you're shadow defending and you have to make a backward save. So give this pack a shot if Shadow Defense is something you need to work on. All right, moving on to Diamond, and this is the rank where you probably by now have a baseline understanding of a lot of the mechanics in game. But from my experience, it's that consistency when it comes to Diamond players that is just not quite there yet. So the first pack I'm going to recommend for Diamond players is pretty fitting. It's called Shooting Consistency. Just like it sounds, this pack is pretty straightforward, but it's super effective in training a bunch of different shots you should hit all the time, but probably don't. The second pack for Diamond is going to be Rebounds by Wonder LFT. And I really like this pack because it's not only going to help you get that shooting accuracy piece down, but it also trains your reads, which is something that really starts to ramp up and come into play more quickly when you hit Diamond and the pace of play ramps up. Lastly, it's hard to say exactly, but I think somewhere around the Diamond level of play is when learning how to use your backboard becomes important. So my last pack is going to be a backboard clears exercise. And like I said earlier, Diamond is really where the pace of play picks up. So once you get to the edge of Diamond, I really recommend you devote some time to training backboard play because being able to cover your backboard is something that is critical in the higher ranks. For Diamond honorable mentions, I'm actually gonna go with two training packs that are also going to be more grown-up versions of those gold and plat shooting packs. I don't want to sound like I'm repeating myself, but across the board, something Diamonds need to work on is consistency. So I'm gonna give you two packs called Shots You Shouldn't Miss and Arrow Shots to help fix that. The basic idea here is to just hone in on your shooting from off angles and really make sure you're able to generate powerful touches from any position. You can't go wrong practicing these two packs. Okay, moving on to the champ bracket, and now I can finally share my favorite training pack in all of Rocket League, and that is Aerial Off Wall. Now this is a pack that you can honestly start working on in Diamond or even Plat if you're feeling ambitious, but like the name sounds, it becomes super useful when you get up to the champ level of play because it's going to combine your aerial and wall play ability, which is something that I really think starts to come together in the champ ranks. Another pack I had to save for champ is a pack called Little Bit of Everything by Komodo. This pack is great because, as the name suggests, it brings a bunch of different skills that you probably should have in your kit by the champ ranks together in one pack. So whether you need to work on aerials, wall play, or just shooting consistency, definitely take a look at this pack. And onto my last pack for champ, I decided to include a pack called Double Touch Consistency. Now, this was a really tough add for me personally because I wanted to include so many different packs in this slot, but I was trying to think, if I only have one slot to include a pack, what is actually the most useful and most relevant mechanic to practice? And in my mind, it has to be getting down your wall reads and double taps. Something that you'll probably notice if you watch higher level of play is how often players use the walls and backboard to create self passes. And if you can simply generate more touches on the ball, you're going to win games with so much more ease in champ ranks than if you devoted all that time to learning something like a ceiling shot or an air dribble. With that being said though, moving on to honorable mentions, I am going to include a few different packs to train things like wall to air dribbles, ceiling shots, and speed flips. Because if you do want to learn this stuff, champ is probably the place to do it. But with that being said, definitely feel free to check them out if you're looking to improve these specific mechanics. All right, but moving on to Grand Champ training, if you're at this point, you're right around my level of play, or you're just watching this to see what the hell a Grand Champ might train. So since this section falls right around my rank, I'm just gonna give you my favorite packs that I've been training lately. All right, to kick it off, my number one Grand Champ pack has got to be Corrupted. What this pack is basically a very advanced redirect, double tap, and wall play pack that really pushes your mechanics to the next level. And so if you're ever feeling ambitious, try this pack and you'll get exactly what I mean. Another amazing pack I discovered recently is High Clear Defense by Lethemir. This pack includes a lot of really high aerials and ceiling reads, which to be honest, aren't super useful for most players, but if you are in GC, this is the kind of thing you're gonna start to see all the time. And finally, my last pack for GC players has to be Clears / Backboard Reads by Bakito. Now this pack is a really high-paced defensive pack, and it's not for most players. But just like with Les pack, it trains the sort of scenarios that, while not all that common at the lower levels, come up a ton in high-ranked gameplay. And for that reason, it gets my last spot on the list. Finally, moving on to honorable mentions, you might laugh at what I'm about to say, but I'm giving the same honorable mentions for GCs that I gave to bronzes, and that's free play. In all seriousness, guys, I know you may have expected me to say something like Justin's redirect pack or something nutty like that, but the thing is, when you get to the high levels of play, you can train all you want, but nothing matches actually competing at a high pace, which is why I think just practicing going as fast as possible in free play is one of the most productive things you can do as a high-ranked player, which is why it gets my honorable mention even for Grand Champ players. But there you have it, guys. Maybe one day when I hit SSL, I'll have training packs for them too. But for the time being, these are what I think are the best training packs for each rank in Rocket League. That being said, I intentionally left out a lot of packs that train flashy but less useful mechanics like flip resets or redirects. So if you're looking for more on that, definitely stay tuned and let me know in the comments below if a freestyle training pack list sounds interesting. Anyways, guys, I do hope that was helpful, but at the end of the day, it's only what I think. So definitely make sure to share what you think of my list in the comments below. And of course, let me know if I missed out on any good packs. Also, I know there were a lot of packs in here, so if someone wants to be a hero and link all the codes with timestamps in a comment below, I'll definitely pin it down below. That's about all for me though, guys. But before the video ends, if you're interested in entering any of the giveaways I'm currently running on my other socials, make sure to check out my Discord and my TikTok if you haven't already. That's all I've got though, so thank you all so much for watching, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Later, guys.